Thank you all for joining. We're going to talk about an SPFX data table web part using PnP reusable controls. My name is David Warner. I'm co-presenting with Chandani Prajapati. Would you like to introduce yourself, Chandani?
Yeah, sure. I'm Chandani Prajapati. I am a SharePoint developer. I am a blogger and open source contributor. First of all, thanks to PnP Community to give me opportunity to present my demo. And many thanks to Hugo and David to help me to prepare a demo. And yeah, this is my first talk, so I am very excited but a bit nervous. Over to you, David.
Awesome, thank you. And as mentioned, this is her first demo. In fact, all of our presenters today are first timers, so we look forward to that. And Chandani is coming in through the Sharing is Caring buddy system, so we'll talk a little bit more about that at the end. Today, though, we're going to be focusing on the sample that she created. Now, it's a data table sample, and what it does is it takes in information from lists and libraries and renders them in a very nice configurable way that you can drop as a web part. So it provides important features like search and filter, pagination, column selection, column ordering, exportation, alternative row formatting with background colors, and more. So many cool features, and all of them are configurable. So let's go directly to the demo and see how to take advantage of this particular web part. Now, to set the context, what you're looking at is a list that we've created of PnP community contributors. We've got a few items included here based on their home country, favorite sport, and favorite season. Now, we could always, of course, use list formatting for some of this stuff, but we might want to drop it on the web part in an interactive way. So I'll go over to a page and I'll edit that page, and we've already got the web part loaded, so I'll just do a search on data table. We see it's here. First thing is we're given the opportunity to configure the web part. So we'll click configure, and we see immediately we're provided with a number of options to to configure our web part. First of which, of course, is scoping to the list that we would like to include. The next is selecting the information that we would like to have displayed. So we'll go ahead and include everything, the actual title and or community contributor, favorite sport, season, home country. We're then able to turn on and off sorting. So we're going to be able to sort on sport and season. We'll include those two. You see that when I hover over sport and season after selecting them, I can sort on them. So that is something that you can include. We can also enable search, so we can define exactly what we want to be included inside of our search. So we can exclude things. If we only want to scope to a certain data piece of our list, we can include that. So once again, we'll include favorite sport and favorite season. As we move to the second page, we've got additional opportunities for configurability. We can enable exportation to CSV or PDF. So we'll talk a little bit more about that. And of course, we can do pagination, which is very cool. We see the different row options down here, so we'll take a look at that as well. And we can define the order in which our items are showing up in our data table here. So we can click to move sport up to the beginning, or we can actually drag and drop as well. So if I was to do that, then we'll see that show up. And if I turn off and on pagination, we see that occurs as well. So we see now sport is showing at the beginning. We can also set the colors. So if I wanted to change like the background color, of course, you know me, I'm going to go with a light purple and then perhaps a light orange if I wanted to get a little bit more branded here with my website. So we have a lot of configurability. Now you may be thinking this isn't matching exactly to the brand that we typically see within SharePoint out of the box. And that is something that Chandani is working on. We're going to be setting this up to be more comparable to the look and feel of standard SharePoint, so it looks a little bit more natural. But a lot of very powerful features, so I will just republish here, and we'll take a look at how some of that works. So now we had turned on the ability to sort by season. So we can see I can now sort by season, or I can sort by sport, for example. So when we look at season, we look at Hugo. His favorite season is popcorn seasoning. So he said his favorite sport is cycling. And he said that means cycling on and off his computer. but we're able to search, right? So I can say popcorn. And now I'm able to see that. And it filters to just that item. I can also include the rows, right? So if I include 10, then we've got 6 total items. So if I just wanted to paginate to the 6th, I can do that. Now I can also export via PDF. So I'm going to click on that and open up, and we'll see everything is included there for us, right? So everything that we included. But what's really cool is if I just said, I only want to see popcorn, or I only want to see the matches for pop, which is Hugo's popcorn favorite season, and then I export again, then the exportation only includes the items that were actually filtered. So that's a pretty cool feature too, because if you're only looking to include the information that matches your search, then you're able to do that. Alternatively, if I went to all and included all and exported, then we do get all of the items. We see all 6 items are showing up there. So Chandani has done a fantastic job here. The capabilities here are open to extensibility, so there's always options to include additional features, and because it is open source. So I'm going to go back to the slides, and we're going to hand the mic over to Chandani to walk us through the code. Chandani?
Yeah, sure. So let's start with the folder structure of our React data table. So first one is the React data table webpart.ts file. So in this file, I have added all the configuration for the webpart property. And from here, we will pass the property to the our iProps to render the data in the main component. Now next file is the React data table.tsx. So this is the main parent component, so in which we will render the our data. And next one is the service file. So service file, in this service file, I have used the PnPjs to PnPjs for all the API communication, like the get fields, get list items, and all. Then next one is the common folder. So in a common folder, there are 3 child components. So I have modularized the code in the different folder. So first one is the export list item to CSV. Second one is export list item to PDF. And third one is the pagination. Next is React data table webpart.ts file. So yeah, first method is get property pane configuration. So in this method, I have divided all the property pane configuration in different groups, like a list configuration, and another one is the searching and sorting configuration, and like advanced features and all. So first one is the list configuration. So in list configuration, there are 3 properties. Well, first one is webpart title, second one is the list picker, and third one is the field picker, fields for the particular list. So for React data table webpart.ts render method, so in render method, I have passed all the properties, and I have called get selected list fields. So in this method, I am getting all the fields of the selected list. Now React data table webpart.tsx file. So in this first one is the component did mount method. So this method will call when our webpart will render. So in this, I have called the get selected list item method. So in get selected list item method, I am calling a service to get the list item based on selection of list and fields. And after that, I have mapped this data in the table container format, which I need for that. And then I have set this data in the state. And second one is the render method. Yeah, so in this is the main part of the our component. So in this method, our web part will be rendered. So first one is the placeholder. So when initially we will add our web part, it will show the placeholder to edit the property pane configuration. So after property pane configuration, second one is the enable download as CSV component. So this is the child component, and here all are the configurable. If user want to show this button enable download as CSV, then user have to turn on from the property configuration. And here I have passed all the properties are dynamic, so same as a same feature as a download as PDF. And main part is a table container. Here it is divided into 3 parts. First one is table heading, second one is table body, and third one is table pagination. So in table heading, data will be short. The data will be coming from the selection of fields, and here also have a sorting functionality. If user will select from property pane configuration, if he needs sorting, and for the particular field, then sorting icon will show will visible on the particular fields. Then table body. In table body, all the data will render from the list items. And yeah, here one background color property, and it is dependent on the our property and configuration of the odd color and even color. So it will be set based on this, based on that. And third one is the pagination. So in table footer, there is a pagination component, and this pagination component will be rendered in the table footer. So that's all from my side. Back to you, David.
Awesome. Thank you, Chandani. All right. Well, we hope you enjoyed that. We wanted to highlight, though, that this was an opportunity for Chandani. She was nervous. She didn't want to do it by herself in terms of the presentation. But this is a feature that's available via Sharing is Caring, the buddy system. So we invite everyone to take advantage. We would love to see your demos. We would love to see you present. And sometimes it's a little easier to do when you're able to present with someone that you're comfortable with. So please take advantage of this. We would love to help you be more involved if that's something you would like to do. Other than that, we'd like to thank you. The link is here available. All the SPFX samples, the SPFX React controls, and the specific link to the sample is available there. We'll put it in the chat. Patrick, back to you.
Great stuff. Very cool, clean implementation there.